Hello there everybody and welcome back to another episode of Terraria Mod Development. It has been a long time since I've done a video and I'm hoping that these videos will now be out a lot more because it is New Year and I have a new I haven't heard the quality of yet, so we're going to find out in this video. Anyway, we're going to be working on a summoning weapon and we're going to start the basic stuff for the summon. The first thing we're going to do is go into our items, weapons, and create a new class. I've called this tutorial summon stuff because I've already created the images. I'll show that to you. Weapon. Tutorial summon stuff, and I've just recolored the existing thing in. Okay, so we want to be using xma.framework. No, we don't. Using Terraria. Using Terraria.modloader, and I've put using Terraria.i. Changes to a public class. Mod item. Public. Override set static defaults, display name dot set default, and we're just going to call this tutorial summon stuff tooltip dot set default to summons a summon, which is what I've called the spirit. Anyway, set defaults. Item dot damage was set to 100. Item dot width, I don't know. We're just going to put 20 height equals 20 as well. Item dot use time will be 30. Item.use animation will also equal 30. Item.use style will be 1 because we'll be swinging the staff. Item.no melee equals true. This is not a melee weapon. I feel like I've already put that in an existing one, but I'll put it there anyways. Item.knockback will do 2. Item.value equals item.buyPrice 0, 1, 0, 0. Item.rare equals, we'll just put 4 because why not? Item.useSound equals, and we'll be using soundid.item44. Then item.shoot mod.projectile type, and we'll call it tutorial summon spirit, and item.shoot speed set to 10, and item.buff type equals mod.buff type, and I called it Tutorial summon spirit buff, I believe. Let me just check. Summon spirit buff, yeah. And then item dot buff time equals that. And that is 60 seconds. So, work out what you need for that. Okay. Public override alt function use return true. Public override shoot term player dot alt function use is not equal to 2. let's let's put that back, otherwise it's going to be an error. Public override use item. If player dot alt function use equals 2, player dot minion NPC target aim, otherwise return base dot use item player. Okay, so that's everything you need for stuff. What we're doing is giving an alternate function use, which will allow the player to tell the minion to target a NPC. And we'll be going into that. There's also something I forgot to do up here, which is very important. Item.summon equals true. This is true if this weapon summons something. An item.mana, mana, 10. The amount of mana used. So it is a magical item, but you don't need to set this to magic. Okay, so let's save that. Let's jump over to the buff. I think that one. Okay. So in buff, create a new, add a new class called tutorial. Summon spirit buff. And again, using Terraria.mod loader. Set this to public. Point, did I set this to public? Yes, I did. Mod buff. Public override set defaults. Display name dot set default. Summon spirit. Description dot set default. A summon. Summon spirit app will fight for you. Main dot buff, no save. Type equals true. And main dot buff, no time display. Type equals true. Okay. Public override update. And you want to make sure to choose the player one. Show your player. For your player equals player dot get mod player of mod tutorial. Yeah, for some reason that doesn't seem right. Let's do the other method. For your player mod. That's better. If player dot owned projectile counts for mod dot projectile type of, what do I tutorial summon spirit is greater than 0. Nope, not question mark, is greater than 0. Then you want to do mod tutorial player dot, we haven't actually made this, summon spirit minion equals true. If no tutorial player dot summon spirit minion, then player delete buff index, buff index minus minus. else. Player buff time for buff index equals 18000. Okay, so that's all you need for this. Let's jump into our tutorial player to okay, let me sort it out. Public bull summon spirit minion equals false. Summon spirit minion equals false, and I don't believe I need it anywhere else. No. Okay. Now we come on to the annoying part. We're going to set up a basic thing for minions, and this is also going to be showing you how to set up some kind of global behaviors for NPCs, projectiles, etc., etc. So I'm going to call this minion AI, and I haven't used tutorial minion AI because this is a thing, and this is going to be an abstract class which takes on mod projectile using Terraria.mod, right? The public override AI. That. Now we're going to create two abstract classes. Public abstract void check active. Then public abstract void behave. And then we're going to do check active here. Behavior. So what this is doing is we're creating a class that will be used with minions, which will check if the minion is active, and then it will have the behavior of the minion. Which we've got these set to abstract, which means they have to be overridden when we ever this. So we're going to do that now. I think I've got something. Yep, I'm missing a bit of code. I haven't got it on my phone. Nope, I know why. Because we were going to not worry about it. Okay, so we're going to add class tutorial summon spirit. The public class, and we're going to take it. Minion AI. Now you'll see this has a red line underneath. It's because we haven't implemented the check behavior. So import those and we'll leave them like that. Public override set static defaults. Main. Nope, hang on, there's a reason that's not working. Because I haven't taken in these. Main dot watch frames for projectile type equals, and let's just quickly jump over to the spirit. Is here, as you can see, it's got four, so we'll set that to four. Main dot project pet projectile dot type projectile Oops, that's what it's in. Make sure you then projectile ID dot sets dot minions sacrificable of projectile dot type true. Projectile ID dot sets dot min for projectile ID for projectile dot type equals true. Projectile ID dot sets dot minion targeting feature projectile dot type equals true. And this just handles when you right click, it targets the public override set defaults. Projectile.net important equals true. Projectile.width equals 24. Projectile.height equals 24. Because I'm not actually sure what those sizes are. Projectile.friendly equals true. Projectile.minion equals true. And let me also comment some stuff. This is true if the projectile is a minion. Projectile minion slots equals 1. How many minion slots are taken up? I believe that's what that's for. Projectile.penetrate equals 1. Projectile.timeleft equals 1800. Nope, not 1, minus 1. Because it's not destroyed after it's whatever. Tile collide equals false. Projectile.ignore water equals true. And then leave the rest as it is. Let's go into the check active. Undo player. Player equals main dot player. That's the projectile dot owner. And then undo tutorial player. So your player equals player dot get player tutorial player and then mod. Okay, if player dot dead tutorial player dot what do I call it, summon spirit minion equals false. If tutorial player dot summon spirit, then we want to do projectile dot time left equals 2. This will basically force this to be set to 2, and then when you die 2 1 0 it will go. Let's go to leave behavior for now. Behavior will just stay as is because we're gonna do that in a later episode. So we'll get rid of the throw, otherwise it's just gonna cause an error. Then public override select type. Why is that? Has it changed? Might have changed. Do not for the life of me remember. To override aim? Okay. I'm not sure, but we're going to have to test this out. I'll have to do some research into why that's not working. I think it might be in a different version. And there's an error somewhere. There's our error. Are you really going to be picky about that? I don't know why it's been throwing that error recently. I mean, might mean I have to reinstall Terraria, but... Okay. Loading everything. I'm expecting there to be an issue with code somewhere. Single player. We'll do the normal world. And then let's get out. Stuff which is not here? Am I being blind? Okay, there's an issue. I'm gonna have to figure out what's going on. I think it might be due to that error. So I'll be right back, and as soon as I found the error, I will show you how to fix it. Be back in a minute. Okay, I'm back, everyone. The reason that I'm not working is because I updated Visual Studio. And it, when this is set to 14, it throws the error. If we go build, it didn't throw the error. Then I have no idea why it just suddenly fixed itself. And now we should be able to test the thing out. How annoying that was. And let's click that one. Okay. So hopefully this time it works. I might have to rebuild the solution, I'm not sure. You just ensure it's on, yep. There it is. Let's hope it works. Okay, our spirit just decided to leg it because its behavior is set to really odd. But as of right now, it will just fly forwards because of the shoot speed and everything. And I was hoping it'd be idle, but it's not, which is irritating. It will also not allow me to use it because it was still going through the world. But I'm trying to find an enemy somewhere. Head into the corruption, I believe. Also want to turn this to day. Do that. Okay. Try and target this ice slime. Okay, it doesn't even work properly. As you can see, I'm trying to shoot at the thing, but of course we don't have any AI at the moment, and that's what we're going to be covering in one of the upcoming episodes. It's not going to be the next episode, I believe it's the episode after, and the AI will have something in it, because as of right now what it will do is just shoot forward without any AI happening. So until next time, thank you all for watching and goodbye.